Hi, it's Jake here. Welcome to The Voluntary Life. I wanted to do an episode this week about the topic of personal productivity, time management, getting things done, and overcoming that sense of overwhelm that I think so many of us have experienced. I know that for myself, when I went into business, just the sheer volume of work and decisions to be made and stuff to organize, things to do, tasks to complete, I found completely overwhelming at first. It was, really quite stressful. And the only real technique that I had for dealing with that was to work longer hours, which, after a while just becomes really exhausting. Time management is not something that came easily or naturally to me. I really had to work at it. And I also spent quite a long time looking around at what is out there in terms of, best practice or good knowledge on this subject. So I wanted to share with you the approach that that I found to be massively helpful. In fact, it really did change the way that I worked and the way that I organized myself. It changed my life. It was a fantastically helpful approach called Getting Things Done by David Allen, which you may have heard of. GTD is the acronym that it goes by. I won't give a summary of GTD because I think the easiest thing is just to read the book. It's a very well-written book, and David Allen's also got lots of lectures online and other audio books and things that you can find too. So I highly recommend taking a look at that yourself. But I did want to share what I found useful about the getting things done approach, because if you haven't read about GTD, then hopefully this will give you a bit of an overview of why it might be helpful. And even if you are already using that approach, it might be interesting to think about, why it works for you as well. So when I realized that I really wanted to get a better handle on my workload, I read a lot of books on time management, and there are hundreds out there. And I would say that 99% of them boil down to really a few very basic messages. The messages are, if you want to manage your time, you have to prioritize more effectively. You're not prioritizing. So what you need to do is decide on what is important and do the important things first. And the other main task, and the other main idea that 99% of these books come up with is, don't shirk the tough decisions. If you need to make a decision, make the decision, because otherwise you will be sort of stuck waiting for decisions to get made. So personal productivity is all about making the tough decisions, prioritizing, and doing the most important thing first. And I found that very limited in terms of how much help it gave me. I tried applying a lot of the ideas around those basic concepts, and I found, the mileage that I got out of them to be helpful in some ways, but pretty superficial. And ultimately, one of the most superficial things about the sort of traditional time management approaches is that they really are just saying, you aren't organized because you aren't disciplined. You need to be more disciplined, and then you'll be more organized. And that is quite a superficial understanding of the problem of time management, I think. And what's interesting about Getting Things Done, or GTD, is that it's a completely different approach, because it actually takes into account the really amazing relationship between your conscious organizing brain, which is very good and useful at doing some things, and your unconscious, which is always coming up with new ideas and remembering things that you might want to do and thinking of things that you haven't done and so forth, and stressing you out with a constant background noise of stuff that your conscious mind, if you follow the kind of must prioritize, must do the important things first approach, your conscious mind is constantly trying to say, no, don't tell me about something else. I'm trying to do the important thing first. Whereas your unconscious comes up with all these bright ideas and interesting things and so forth. And getting things done is the only approach that I found that really is able to harness the unconscious, not ignore it, but harness it so that you can actually use, you know, both your logical, rational, conscious mind, and also your intuitive, creative, unconscious mind to get things done, to do what you want and achieve the things that you want to achieve. And that's what I found so interesting about getting things done as an approach. And it's a very compassionate and nurturing approach because it sort of uses your whole mind to get things done. And I don't have any better system than that. So I'm a huge fanboy of getting things done. And that's why I highly recommend that you read it. But here's the things that I found useful about it. The first thing that I think is really, really helpful in getting things done is the idea of getting things out of your head. All of the sort of approaches and methods that David Allen talks about in getting things done are around the idea that, you know, if you want to get a handle on your workload and in your business and in your life, you've got to get it all out of your head so that you're not trying to remember things and having things constantly pop into your mind. And so that you're able to, in a way, just see all of your projects and tasks and everything in front of you. And he has a lot of different ways of getting things out of your head. One of the ones that I really like is the idea of doing a core dump, what he calls a core dump, which is basically, it's like the analogy is when a computer crashes, then what it does is it just dumps everything that was in RAM onto a text file. And that is called a core dump. I'm probably getting that horribly wrong technically, but that's the basic idea, is that it just writes out everything that was in its memory when it's crashing. And that analogy is sort of applied to yourself, which is like if you feel like you're really being overwhelmed, one of the things that he suggests that you do on a regular basis is just sit there and write everything out that is in your head. And that could be everything from, you know, pick up milk to must resolve dispute with client or whatever it is. He just says, just get it all out of your head. Don't try and organize anything until you've got everything down on paper. Then you can go through and actually sort of use a different part of your brain to then organize what those things are. But the getting things out of your head is a really, really helpful approach. And I find that enormously helpful. Another way in which he applies this is in writing down all the projects in your life, not just the things that are really important, but in your sort of productivity system, he suggests that you write down every single project that you have in your head that you've been thinking about doing. Again, whether that's a really trivial project, like fixing the light in the bathroom, or whether it's a really huge project, like starting your own business or having kids or whatever it is. And so he talks about just writing down everything, which again, I think is enormously helpful. Another one of the ideas that sort of underpins getting things done is the idea of being conscious of all your commitments. So the idea is that your unconscious mind is always aware that you have an open commitment to do something, either to yourself or to somebody else, and it will keep nagging you unless you have a system where you know that you'll take care of that at some point in the future when it's appropriate to do so. So for example, if you haven't fixed the light fitting in your bathroom for months and months, and it's just something that you know you need to fix, then even if it's a trivial thing compared to a major project like starting a business, it'll still be there taking up room in your head, basically. And so the idea is you actually write out all of the commitments that you have, all the projects that you have in your life, so that you're able to sort of get an overview of everything that you're committed to. And that can be quite daunting at first to do, but actually it makes life so much easier to be aware of all the commitments that you have, because you can also then be conscious of whether or not, you know, it's still appropriate to be committed to a specific project or not. One of the biggest eye-openers for me with the getting things done approach was this idea that one of the reasons people feel overwhelmed is because they haven't filtered through and sorted out and defined the difference between what their aims are and what the action steps are to achieve those aims. So, for example, if you have a big to-do list, you may have a mixture of aims or projects or objectives and action steps to achieve those aims or projects or objectives. So, for example, you might have a to-do list which contains an item like redecorate kitchen and another item like phone Bob. Now, phone Bob would be a specific action, but redecorate kitchen is more like a project. It's an aim, it's a desired outcome, and it could contain many, many, many specific actions to achieve that aim. And it's really helpful to take, for all of your sort of commitments, all your projects in your life, to actually work out what is the desired outcome, what would a successful outcome look like for each one of these, and separate that out mentally from what the action steps are to achieve that aim. And that approach is really, really helpful for everything, even for, you know, if you're going to have a meeting with somebody, a business meeting, whatever, what's the desired outcome of the meeting? If you're clear about what you are trying to do with everything, then you actually have a lot more flexibility about deciding which tasks are appropriate. And it stops you getting stuck in busy work, which you then realize later is actually kind of irrelevant and pointless because it's not working towards an aim that is still relevant for you. Just by naming each aim, it really helps you in identifying whether or not this is something that is relevant for you that you want to be committed to. So I found that really, really helpful, the idea of separating out your objectives from your actions. And then the other thing that with that is the actions themselves. And again, another thing that I found very helpful is the idea of splitting down your tasks or your actions into very, very concrete, tangible steps. Like each action is that you do something, make a phone call or buy something or whatever. It's something that you can actually do without thinking. And this whole approach of creating sort of very, very tangible actions really helps in breaking down big projects into smaller sub-projects, and from smaller sub-projects, smaller tasks. And it's that whole thing of, you know, any big problem, you can only really tackle it one bit at a time. And this sort of approach really helps you to break down a big problem into specific action steps that you can take. And that is something that I found enormously helpful, in especially at work, in terms of major projects, to actually identify what all of the sort of sub-projects would be and little objectives underneath this big objective of finishing the project. And then for those, to identify what all the action steps or tasks would be. That is a really helpful way of getting organized. Another thing that I found really helpful about getting things done as an approach is the idea of allowing yourself to record and store uncommitted projects. You might have experienced that thing where, you know, you have some dreams, some ideas, some things that you would quite like to do, maybe, and you think about them, but you also have an ambivalence about thinking about them, because if you think about them, you're spending time on them, which might mean that you should really be doing something about them and committing to them, but you're not yet ready to commit to them, so you don't want to think about them, but then you are thinking about them. You can really tie yourself in knots like this. At least I can. And just a really useful and simple idea that that David Allen talks about in the book is the idea of a someday maybe list of projects, where you can write down all of these projects. If you're not an entrepreneur, you might have start a business as a someday maybe project, and you might want to think about it, but be conscious of the fact that you are not yet committed to that goal. You're just thinking about it as a someday maybe project. And by writing all of these someday maybe projects down, I found it really helpful in actually making my dreams and my desires and my wishes more tangible before I'm fully committed to doing them, to decide, you know, is this a dream that I want to follow? Is this something that I really want to make a reality? And that I found a really helpful way of also just freeing up your mind from things that pop into your head when you're trying to get something done. Another one of the ideas that he talks about in the book is having a trusted system. And this is something that, you know, David Allen has a lot of suggestions about sort of really specific things of how to organize your inbox and all these other things. And many of those things are useful, and there are also loads of software applications out there for making your own getting things done system. And there's some great tips in there, but I think the most useful thing about it is just the idea of having a trusted system. So in other words, if your mind knows that when you have something you need to remember, there's a place to write it down, that you will see it in a timely manner when you need to, then your unconscious can kind of let it go, and it can stop nagging you about it when you're trying to do other things. And so I, for example, use a software application for getting things done. I write down all of the things that come into my head. When I think of them, I then process those things on a weekly basis and work out whether or not they're action steps of a specific project that I'm already doing, or if it's a new project and so forth. And I work through looking at all of my projects and seeing whether or not they're still relevant and so forth. And this is the kind of thing that he means by a trusted system. And that itself is just a really, really helpful thing. Even if you adapt the approach to your own system and have your own way of doing things, the key thing that's helpful there is if your brain knows that there's somewhere that you can put things. So for example, I used to have one system at work with all of my work-related tasks linked to individual projects and so forth. And on my PDA at the time, it would be a phone now, I had my personal tasks. Now, some people think that, you know, you should really always have everything in one single system. I chose to do it that way because I could track time on my work projects, and I could actually have individual tasks that I would then log time against. And I was always able to access that anyway. So I put those tasks on the work database, and I put my own personal tasks on my PDA. And that worked for me. Other people have different approaches. Some people use everything in software, and some people go all paper for writing things down. It doesn't matter. The point is just to have your own system, which is enormously helpful. One of the other things that getting things done enables you to do is really to be very adaptable and flexible to changes in the plan that you had for your day or time commitments and so forth. And there are lots of ways in which it does this, but just to talk about one of them, is the idea of having contexts for tasks. So for example, you may have a whole series of to-do items or tasks in many, many different projects, which are all things that you need to buy. So for example, you might need to buy paint for your redecorating the kitchen. You might need to buy stationery for some project that you're doing in your office. You might need to buy something else for the holiday that you're about to go on. And the idea of context is related to each task. You define a context. For example, it might be an errand. And then when you're out and about shopping, you can look at all your errands and see, oh, is there anything else I need to buy? So that when you're in a shopping center, you can just get all of that done at once. And he has other examples, which are phone calls. If you have them all as a particular context for each task, which is it's a phone call, then if you want to be really, if you want to just blast through a whole series of phone calls, if you're waiting for an appointment and you've got some time on your hands, you know, you can just make all those calls one after another, because you can actually sort of select by context all the tasks that are relevant for where you are at that particular time. I found that, again, very helpful. And these are all just sort of specific techniques and tools that are talked about in the book. And you can find them all if you read Getting Things Done. I think the point of it all is that they're all ways of just freeing your mind from stress and clutter and stuff coming up. And it's a way of freeing your mind without sort of just repressing it. I think the whole idea of I must focus on the most important thing and get those things done first and I must be disciplined with my time, that whole approach, I think, misses out on the fact that your unconscious is constantly popping things into your mind to remind you of things if you haven't done them, even if they are trivial and you're trying to concentrate on something else. Whereas if you have this kind of trusted system where you've written stuff down and you've been able to go through and assess on a regular basis and so forth, if you have that, then it actually means that when you want to get on with one specific task, you can just really get in the zone and do it without your mind kind of wandering off to the other things that you know you need to get done, because you sort of can trust that it's all there and, you know, you will get to it at an appropriate time. So that's just a kind of overview of the Getting Things Done approach. I hope that's helpful, and I'd love to hear any feedback you have. So if you have any thoughts about this, please do feel free to comment on the website or send me an email. And thank you so much for listening.